What would a kitchen look like if it didn't have a bin? Is that a possibility? A third of all food from farm to fork is never eaten. Every commercial kitchen is going to waste food. It's a natural byproduct of the production process of preparing food at scale. But we need an urgent focus on this issue to have a chance of reducing it. We need to challenge the status quo. We need to point the most powerful technology and the advancements that we have at our disposal. And if we do so, I'm optimistic that we could really have a chance of halving food waste worldwide. What's stopping you from realizing the opportunity that reducing food waste presents? I've been with Winnow for 10 years, and honestly, I didn't expect to be curiously looking in bins for that amount of my career. I'm David Jackson, I'm the Director of Marketing and Public Affairs at Winnow. So at Winnow, we develop AI tools to help chefs run more profitable and sustainable kitchens by cutting food waste in half. Food is precious, food is life, food brings us together. That's why everybody at Winnow is bonded in a mission to try and reduce food waste across the whole hospitality sector. Chefs don't have time to manually key in or use spreadsheets or even pen and paper to measure food waste in their kitchen. So we solved that problem with artificial intelligence. Winnow works by putting effectively a supercomputer into the kitchen. The field of AI that we work in is computer vision, so we're teaching a machine to see the food as it's being thrown away in real time. We've banked up over 320 million food waste images from kitchens around the world. We've used that data set to train an AI model to be able to recognize food as it's thrown away. Our AI will then do all the hard work and record exactly what was thrown away, the weight and the cost. And then we are able to give teams insights that we know can materially reduce food waste in these kitchens while doing the right thing for their business and also the planet. So we have a test rig here. We have a plastic in this case, but a piece of corn on the cob that unfortunately has to be thrown away. So it goes into the bin. The system will take a picture, and we call this throw and go. So the user throws the food into the bin, the AI identifies that it's corn on the cob, allocates a cost to that item. We aggregate all of those transactions over the course of service. And the next day, the team will get a report that pinpoints exactly where food waste occurred and where they should focus to drive it down. We say what gets measured gets managed. Food waste is just really difficult to measure. And so using technology like Winnow can help accelerate change by giving precise measurement of where food waste occurs and crucially what it's costing them as a business. From a planetary perspective, if food waste was a country, it would be the third largest emitter of greenhouse gas emissions after America and China. That's because when food waste goes into landfill, it creates methane, which can be up to 80 times more potent as a greenhouse gas compared to carbon dioxide. It costs the economy about $1 trillion every year of lost output. With Winnow, we focus on the hospitality sector, where somewhere in the region of $100 billion worth of food is wasted every year. Now, you can look at that as a big problem, but we prefer to look at it as an opportunity. Today, Winnow is saving somewhere in the region of 87,000 tons of carbon dioxide equivalent. To put that into context, that's enough energy to power the homes of a small town for an entire year. And typically, a site using Winnow could expect to save tens of thousands of dollars within the first year. Winnow works all over the world with the likes of Hilton, Marriott, Accor, IKEA, in all of their customer restaurants, food service businesses like ISS and Compass Group, and many, many others in almost 3,000 locations. A great win for Marriott and for the fight against food waste came here in the UK just this year. Marriott UK and Ireland announced that food waste had been cut by 25% across over 50 hotels. Winnow works internationally with Hilton Hotels. One notable initiative was the Green Breakfast Project, which aimed to reduce food waste at the breakfast buffet. Almost all hotels have breakfast, and unfortunately, it's a source of food waste. We were able to cut post-consumer waste during that just 4 months by over 60%, and that's something that we're now looking at scaling up across the rest of Hilton worldwide. Hilton, in some of their hotels, will have a bin-free Monday, where the team literally remove all of the bins, and the team have to use everything that is in the kitchen. It's a mindset shift. It needs training and culture change. So innovation has a massive role in solving the problem of food waste. And with the advent of technologies like AI, we should be pointing that new power at this really significant problem. I would like to see a future where every kitchen is able to benefit from this type of technology, that we make a material reduction in the food that's being wasted in our restaurants, in our hotels, and the sector at large, and that we inspire the rest of the world and us in our homes to make changes that ultimately see food waste reduced by half, which we so desperately need. Food is too valuable to waste, and we've set ourselves a big goal to be saving $1 billion worth of food every year. Cross-sector collaboration is crucial if we're going to have a chance. We need businesses, innovation, NGOs, and the public at large to come together and collaborate to deliver a reduction in food waste worldwide. The good news is this problem is man-made and it's eminently solvable if we can all come together. Food waste is one of the defining problems of our time. If we're serious about overcoming the challenges that are presented to us in real terms because of the climate emergency, we have to solve the food waste problem. The hospitality sector has a massive role in driving down food waste, not only in commercial kitchens, restaurants, hotels, but in terms of changing the way that we all think about food. Chefs are tastemakers, and our experience working with brilliant, talented chefs all over the world is that nobody wants to throw food away. And if we give people the tools and the information and the knowledge, that we can all have a material impact on this problem.